Every patient has a story that's unique and inspiring. Every week I get re-inspired to go back and do the work that I need to do. Oncology, both the nature of the patients and the nature of the fact that we have a lot of progress to make in the illness, made it an exciting and challenging field that I really wanted to become involved in. It's a field in which combines both kind of scientific inquiry as well as compassion. Part of what I do is run a basic science laboratory. You know, we're very focused on the biology of breast cancer, and in particular, the role of one of the hereditary breast cancer genes called BRCA1. Now we're come to realize that breast cancer, and many cancers, are really large collections of distinct diseases. The technology over the past 5 years really advanced dramatically to allow us to start getting better classification of these cancers and say, not that a woman has breast cancer, but they have a particular kind of breast cancer that can really help us guide, determine both their natural history and what treatments they will respond best to. And thus, the concept of, you know, targeted therapy, all right? And that's an essential part of personalized medicine. I work in the Women's Center here under the leadership of Dr. Topmeyer. And so I see patients about one day a week and see patients in kind of all stages of disease and work in together with a team of nurses, surgeons, radiation oncologists together to craft treatments for each of these women. It's a humbling field in which we clearly see the limitations of our current medicine. But it's also a very inspiring field because we constantly get to see people under outrageous circumstance dealing with their circumstance with greater grace than one would imagine. And I'm constantly inspired by how my patients deal with their situation. What's really exciting is that there is a sense of optimism in the field of oncology that's growing because of these changes in the basic science. You know, we're really dependent on and grateful for private philanthropy to supplement government funding and other sources that we have here to really allow us to do this work. You know, it's a real privilege to be able to do this work, but obviously we need resources to be able to continue it. The fantasy in the future would be that every patient who walks into cancer, part of your diagnosis will be a full molecular kind of catalog of what happened in your cancer. And from that list, together with information about the person, craft a treatment that would have the greatest chance of eliminating the cancer for them. Occasionally I wake up and go, wow, it's great to be able to, you know, do the things that I'm allowed to do here, which is really see patients, do the science, and then really see the effect of the science on the patients and the effect of the patients on the science. And it's you know, very gratifying to be able to do that. So it's really a community. No one person, you know, does this, but it's a real privilege to be honored in this fashion, and also very humbling.